Hello, in this video you will learn about genetic algorithms. So as we know, we use genetic algorithm to solve complex optimization problems and to solve different machine learning problems. In this video you will see basic introduction about genetic algorithms. So first we will see what are genetic algorithms. Genetic algorithms are the search algorithms, and these algorithms are based on the natural selection and natural genetics. As you know, this word, that is genetics, is a branch of biology and it concerned with the study of genes. So genetic algorithms are based on the natural selection and natural genetics. Here you can see the developer of genetic algorithm. Now we will understand genetic algorithm by comparison with natural genetics. In natural genetics, we have chromosomes, and here in genetic algorithm, we are using strings. Here we have genes, and in this algorithm we replace gene with feature and character. Same as you can see the comparison between artificial neural network and the biological network. So same in this, you can see the comparison between natural genetics and genetic algorithm. Here we will replace chromosome with strings, genes with features. We replace this term with string, features, feature values, string position, and structure. These are the biological terms, and here we have these terms that we use in the genetic algorithm. Next is, okay, now we will see the basic introduction about this algorithm. So genetic algorithms start with the population of string. Initially we have population of strings, and with this population you can further generate the successive population of string. After that you can see here we have an example. Suppose for a switch value, if switch is on, we will consider 1. If switch is off, value is 0. Now we will initialize the population for 3 switches. And in this case, we are using here a coin. When you will flip the coin, you can generate the value that is the initial population for the 3 switches. Head is 0, we will consider head 0, tail 1. You can see here, this is the initial population for 3 switches. That is the genetic algorithm, initial population of strings for 3 switches. You can see in this way we can generate the initial population. Now you can see here, initially we have population of strings, and with this population you can further generate successive population of strings. Now we will see how we can generate further population of string with the initial population. So for this we have 3 operations that are involved in the genetic algorithms, that is reproduction, crossover, and mutation. Simple genetic algorithms just copy and swap strings. Now we will see one by one what is reproduction, what is crossover, and what is mutation. First is reproduction. That is the process in which individual strings are copied, and you can see here we will copy string according to their objective function values, that is the fitness value. So how we can copy the string in genetic algorithm? We can select, or we can copy strings with the fitness value. So we will check the fitness value. If fitness value is high, then it will contribute more than one off string in the next generation. In the reproduction step, we will check the fitness value for the string. If fitness value is high, it means string can contribute one or more offspring in the next generation. Next question is, how fitness value is determined? You know the biological term, survival of the fittest. Same we will use in genetic algorithm. For this, we will check the individual ability to survive. And you know the biological term, that is survival of the fittest. Same term we will use in this algorithm. If individual have low fitness value, then it means less chances of survival. If individual have high fitness value, it result offspring in the next generation. So that's how we can determine the fitness value for the each string. If fitness value is high, it means there is a chances for the survival. If fitness value is low, So there is no or less chances of survival. Next is reproduction process. You can see here, according to the fitness value, we will select the string for reproduction. After that, selected strings move to the mating pool. And in the end, you can see we have new population. Now we will see next step, that is crossover. After reproduction, next phase is crossover. So in this case, suppose we have two strings. This is first string and this is second string. Now we will apply here crossover operator. After crossover, you can see here we have new strings 1 and 2. You can see the changes here. After mutation and crossover, you can see we got the final result as new string 1 and new string 2. Last step is mutation operator. Using mutation operator, we can obtain the good result and we can select the string position, and you can see it plays secondary role in the simple genetic algorithm. So this is the simple procedure how genetic algorithms working. If you want to learn more about genetic algorithms, so you can see the book. I provided a link below about the book. The book title is Genetic Algorithm in Search, Optimization and Machine Learning by David E. Goldsberg. So in this book, you can see everything is given in detail. So in this video, we just did short introduction about genetic algorithm. You can see the comparison between natural genetics and the genetic algorithm. Next, you can see here how we can initialize population for switches. Just this example that is given in this book. So you can see here. Next is three basic operations that are involved in the genetic algorithm. And you can see, according to their fitness value, we will select the string, and with the help of selected string, we can generate new population. And you can see here, that's the new generation here. You can see the new string that we generated. So that's a short introduction about genetic algorithm. If you have any question, you can comment below. And thanks for watching this video.